Good morning, friends. I'm Calvin Price, the pastor of Oak Hill Baptist Church in Meridian, Mississippi, and I want to thank you for joining me this morning for a nugget out of God's Word. This morning, I want to tell you that you have something to offer God. We may think that we don't. You may think that you don't, but you do. You may think that what you have is insignificant compared to others, and that is the first mistake. Don't compare what you have to offer God to others. God wants what you have to offer and you alone. And he will take it and use it and do dynamic things, things that you could not imagine or understand in your lifetime. So I want to challenge you today to offer God your best. That's all that he wants. There's a story in John chapter 6 that I want to share with you, one that you're familiar with, but it is a story where Jesus fed 5,000 people with 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. Now, this actually happened on 2 occasions. But in this particular occasion, there's something in the story that is often overlooked by people, and it shows the importance of your contribution to accomplish the task that Jesus wants to accomplish. Please know this, Jesus doesn't need you or me to accomplish his will, but if we offer our best, he will certainly use us as a part of that. In this story, it's late in the afternoon, they're hungry, and the disciples don't know what they're going to do. And in verse 8 of chapter 6 of the book of John, Andrew, Simon Peter's half-brother, he goes to Jesus, and he said this. He said, and one of the disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him in verse 9, now this is the verse that you need to listen to. There is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 small fish, but what are they among so many? Now, did you hear this? This is so important. Right in the middle of this, here's grown men, here's disciples, men who walk with Jesus, and they're doubting what Jesus can do. And in the midst of this, Andrew goes to Jesus and said, look, we have a little boy here who has 5 loaves and 2 fish. Now, please hear me on this. This is the lad who helped Jesus. This is the little boy who helped Jesus. How did he help Jesus? He offered all that he had, and you and I can offer all that we have, and that is the best that we have to offer. Jesus could have fed these people without this young man, but because this young man stepped up and was willing to offer all that he had, Jesus used it to feed over 5,000 people. That is absolutely amazing. And so it should be a reminder to you and to me that even when we think something is impossible, Jesus can do the impossible. He can do it with or without us. We don't know this young man's name. We don't have any idea who he was. But what we do know is that in the middle of this story, a young man stepped up and said, I'm willing to give what I have. He was willing to give up his own livelihood, per se, to feed others. And Jesus said, we'll use it. And they did. But also notice this. The young man was among those that ate with him. Even though he gave his food away, he was among those that feasted at the feet of Jesus. It may be today that you think you don't have much to offer in service to the Lord Jesus Christ. And in one perspective, it may be that you really don't, just like I don't have much to offer. Jesus is not looking for the amount you offer. He's looking for the heart that you offer it with. He's looking for the way you offer it. He's looking to see if you're willing to offer what you have for his glory. This young man did, and God honored it. I want you to know this today, friends. Whatever you think you have or don't have, God can use it. Even if you think it is insignificant, God can use it for his glory, and he will. But you have to be willing to step up and say, this is what I have. This is what I'm willing to give. What are you giving today? Please know this today, my friends, that the Lord Jesus Christ loves you, and I love you too. Please pray with me. Father, help us to offer what we have. Help us to not look at our contributions as insignificant, but to use them for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Until we meet again, my friends, God bless.